Hey guys, well, love you, apparently. God dang, you guys were like sending me questions like rapid fire, but mostly about the Team H stuff. Mostly, I mean, there's one Bugsy and Harley one, and one, like, about several freaking Bugsy multiverse event questions. Okay, first one, where is the Bugsy and Harley series, where is that set? Well, in the Team H universe, not in the main canon, but in the Team H universe, it actually goes where after Team H, Bugsy was going to go marry Donna Troy, like in the main canon, and how everything failed, like in the main canon. Yeah, my videos do have canons. Troy's with someone else, and, you know, Teenage Bugsy notices that Harley isn't with the Joker anymore because of the whole death in the family thing. And yes, I'm implementing her after, like, the death in the family thing where she's like, you know, I don't want to be with the Joker anymore. She's gotten way too crazy. He's not the same Joker. And yeah, it happens after that, but they already did have an established relationship. So, there it is. A little bit of history, because I want to make sure you guys understand this. Let me see. Now, a little bit of established history, or aka headcanon. Teenage Bugsy got with Harley because she was kind of a little bit insane, but he kind of fell for Harley because she's a little bit insane. But, you know, he's seen her actually help this little girl. Different from the other Harleys, where some of them would and others wouldn't, but this Harley is like, you know, she helped this little girl in the street while she was with her hyenas. Like, she was getting groceries for the Joker and stuff, and he was like, she was doing it incognito, but she did help this little kid, like, I don't know, curiosity, because he looked, because back then, he did have his Superman-esque powers, where he's like, oh, that's Harley Quinn. You know, then, you know, after the Joker was in Arkham, and she got to stay out for a bit, kind of like Harley's day out. He basically kept tabs on her and monitored her for a bit, and she was like, why are you following me? And he's like, he plays it off like he's trying to be cool. He basically says, well, I was just seeing if you were up to anything, but, clearly you're not. You stay out of trouble, and Harley starts to get a little curious about him. And from then, she develops a attraction for him. Now, the Joker knows this, so he uses this as a kind of plan. Because in a roundabout way, it's about him getting Batman. In my continuity, yeah, you know where I'm going with the whole Joker thing. Because it's been established in Death of the Family that, well, you know. I don't even have to say it. So, but you want to seek out the other heroes too. So he concocted this plan, and then, you know, Harley was faking being with Teenage Bugsy, and it was pretty much how it was going, and then she just starts to fall from. And Joker goes, give me a minute, folks. Anyway, sorry guys, I'm back. So, I wanted to explain this here because, I mean, the past series is going to be a lot longer than it really is. So I just wanted to kind of talk about this one before I start talking about the other storyline, and I'm only going to tell you a few things about that. because the other storyline has a lot of twists and turns. This one's kind of, well, by the book with me. You know, Harley, you know, Joker goes, Harley, this wasn't part of our plan. You know. And she says, Mr. J, I just can't do it. Joker gets angry. But then, you know, Joker gets angry, he's like, why is that? He's like, she looks at him and she kind of is talking to him, like, in the bathroom, and she glances at Bugsy just kind of asleep. And she goes, Mr. J, he's just so nice, and I didn't know a goody-goody superhero like him could be that nice. Or something like that. I remember, I actually wrote that down. It's because she's not like any other dude she's been with, she's been with a lot of the dudes and the Joker, but it is because he's extremely nice and he's a good person, blah, blah, blah. And somehow she got attracted to that. But, you know. And Joker says, Alright, Harley, if you really insist, then kill him. And then, she goes, I can't. Then the Joker sets up this plan to really just kind of, to just get Bugsy because in my continuity, Joker not cares about Harley, but he needs Harley. He just needs Harley because, you know, he doesn't really... He sees her as a sort of henchman or henchwoman that he can just, like, kind of bang and stuff, and a henchman that's loyal and faithful to him. So he concocts this plan. He's like, okay, Harley, well, meet me here and do bring your charming boyfriend along. And basically, this is back when Teenage Bugsy was weak against one thing. I forget that weakness, but it was one thing. It wasn't kryptonite. Oh yeah, it was this rare metal that he's weak against. It's called... It was a fake name I made up, like, Cardinite. It was called Cardinite.
Yeah, like Cardinite, I know. But,
he was, you know, to use that against him. And while he was not dead, he was like, Harley, you have one choice. Stay with me, or I kill him. He was like, stay with me, or I kill him. Yeah. Because don't you miss... Because he's like, he manipulates her a bit. It's like, don't you miss your pudding? Don't you miss your Mr. J? And she goes, yes. Yes, I do. And goes back with the Joker. And basically, when Teenage Bugsy, when he comes to, he's like, you know, Harley left her with a note. I went back to Mr. J. Please don't look for me. And this broke Teenage Bugsy's heart. He was utterly drained by this fact. Because, you know, he really started to fall for Harley. He really thought that Harley would be the one for him. So he's like, he went back to the Teen Titans because during this time he actually did kind of defect from them, because even though Harley was a criminal, he was willing to basically forsake half of them because of it. And he just kind of went back, saddened. He did try to go and find Harley, like, when he got the note, but then he's like, she's like, go away, I never loved you, blah, 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 this is all a scheme to get into, and the Joker is like, I know that, but I thought, just for an instant, Harley, you actually, you know, she looked at him, and she said, keep dreaming, Flyboy, I never thought of you like that, and I never will. And as, you know, as Teenage Bugsy is, he flew away. He was Super Dude at this point. As Super Dude flew away, she was like, she goes like, I did love you, Mr. B. Like, real, just like real, like low, so the Joker couldn't hear him. Joker couldn't hear her. And when the Joker was in Arkham and she didn't want any part of the Joker's shenanigans for a bit, and when she came back to him in Death of the Family, and like when he was about to like, when he put the red hood on her and she was crying, guess who she went back to? Why not went back to him completely? Because, right? Well, actually, wait a minute. Right after, this happens like right after the Android don't work out. This is kind of like after the Yo-Kai Academy special. Actually, wait a minute, no, wait a minute. It's not right after that. It's like years before, Teenage Bugsy kind of left the DC Universe altogether and went back to his main universe. And this is basically their story. And now he just... He basically, like, tracks him down and they talk.
Yeah.
And basically, it starts from there.
So, now we're gonna get to the... Now we're gonna get to the prison event.
It gets to the prison event. The infinite crisis of multiple Bugsies.
Which, yeah. If you've been watching my videos lately, you know Yonky B
and the others are duplicates of
the main canon Bugsy. From different universes.
You know, the main mock-off Bugsy is from Earth Prime. And the others are from different universes entirely. See, this one doesn't really affect the main videos, but it does affect Team H, and certain things will be influenced by this one story. It's basically Bugsy fighting one of his ultimate enemies from his past, which is basically just Dr. Cube. But, you know, since... And this is what they never freaking do in some of these crossover ones, and this is what they never do in these multiverse stories. You know how there's always, like, different versions of the hero, but never different versions of the villain? Since there's going to be different versions of Bugsy, there's going to be different versions of Dr. Cube to match the different Bugsies in their respective universes. So, yeah. It's going to be kind of like, Spider-Man and the Invisible War. Something like that. And you will see various other allies of Bugsy from the Team H perspective. And various allies from the main Bugsy and a whole bunch of stuff. Also, I'm going to at some point within every Team H episode from the Infinite Crisis for multiple Bugsies, there will be a little bit of information on different Bugsies, like which Earth are they from, and what are their powers, who are they, stuff like that. Yeah, and I'm gonna put them in like little cards. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna use the Yu-Gi-Oh card maker, actually. So, there's that. There are other arcs I'm planning and other arcs I'm retooling. I don't know. I don't want the return of Wrath just yet. Because I really want to rebuild, like, the world of Team H. Since I haven't done it in a while, I want to rebuild the world of Team H. But I'm not, like, rebooting it. Everything that was in the beginning and everything that was in DC Saga, even though I had to rush, will still be there. That's why the Bugsy and Harley series is there, just to fill in some of the gaps that happened in the past. Present day Team H storylines. Because the Bugsy and Harley one is gonna go on for quite some time. Not like a lot, but it's gonna go on for quite some time. Because there's a lot of events and a lot of things that happened. But the present day is gonna be more like the regular story. past one is the past one is the past one is the just the side story, but they're not going to be shown together. They're going to kind of be separate. Like, I might do the Bugsy and Harley one on Monday. You might see the main storyline on May Wednesday or Thursday. Stuff like that. Oh yeah, the Bugsy and Harley storyline will be implemented this Monday. Because really, when I think about it, it's a good kind of concept. And it kind of ties in to why Harley, because you're gonna see Harley, like, in the main storyline, and I just wanted to kind of give you a little bit of context of why she's in there. Yeah, so I want to explain it. You know, some people don't give it a lot of, explanation. You just kind of, they kind of just throw you in there. But I want to give you some, context of why stuff is happening. I just don't want to throw you in and you're just like confused. I want you to actually think about it. But, sorry for the background noise. It happens. But anyways, like I said, I just want to give you context. And there is a certain... Okay, I should tell you about the future storyline because, like I said, I wanted the past, present, and future to kind of run alongside each other. So there is this one future storyline which I'm calling Team H Infinite. It happens like 1,000 years after the formation of Team H. And you know, the original members are still around, but they're old as all crap, and it's up to this, the descendants of Goku, and Bugsy's grandchildren to actually fight this one fight, which I'm not really gonna say what it is. It's just called Team H Infinite. That's all you really need to know. It's gonna be descendants and grandchildren of the main cast. It's gonna be pretty cool. That's all I need to tell you. Okay, like in Spider and Pool, which I wanted to do as a audio drama, but when I think about it, I'm working on two of those, and that. Yeah, working on two of those is enough. So Spider and Pool is strictly in a teenage style with voice acting from me as both Rain Spider and Deadpool. So that's how it's gonna go. But if people want to voice act for certain characters, you know, just ask. Because I don't mind. I really don't mind. If you want to. You know. But that's pretty much it. And you're saying how long the present storyline's gonna go? That's gonna go until... I mean, it's gonna start now, but it won't end until... It'll probably end at the beginning or... middle of February, depending if I get Xenoverse on time, because after I'm done with the present storyline, I'm going to do other things just to give the present storyline of Team H a break for a bit. I'm going to do I'm gonna do DBXV, which is Dragon Ball Xenoverse, which is a storyline through the perspective of Argos Kuro, which is my Dragon Ball Z fan character. Because I doubt they're gonna have your character talk in Xenoverse, so this is just like, I gotta play the game first, but it's like all the other scenes in Xenoverse that basically he's reacting to, because I kind of retooled Argos Kuro just a tad bit. He has a little bit, he's serious, but he's still kind of, he has a little bit more of my personality than he does his standard. He's still going to kind of be a loner at the beginning, and he's going to start acting a little bit like me through it. You know, he kind of makes a transition to being this loner, to being kind of like a combination of Vegeta and Goku in his own way. So, yeah. And also, never did I think I'd actually give him a love interest, and I should say, I gotta play Xenoverse, but he is gonna have a love interest, and you're gonna be like, Bugsy, why did you do it? Why did you do it? Just tell me why. So, yeah, there's gonna be that. And oh, yeah. I was thinking on Friday I could do Amigo videos as new art Bugsy. But again, I have to do it earlier because we all know how Amigo likes to get down, if you know what I mean. I will see you all later. See you kids later. And, oh yeah, seriously, when you got the chance, go to Anime Crave. They are having, during this recording, they are still doing that fundraiser. And it would really mean a lot if you just, like, donated a little bit to Anime Crave. So, because they're giving us all this anime for free, and, you know, I feel like this is a great way for us to pay them back for putting all this anime on this site for us to, like, view without paying a subscription or anything. Or waiting for a week for an anime to become free so we can watch it. That's pretty much it. And I may call these segments when we're taking Q&A answers from various projects. I may call this into the box. Because get it, big $3, into the box. Or into the big three box. Well, anyways, in any case, see you guys later. I'm just putting some content out tonight because I really feel sorry that I didn't do Saturday afternoon. I won't do it next week because the Sonic Show is having this, and the Sonic Show on YouTube is doing a live stream next weekend. They're doing it next weekend on this one, this Sonic convention, and since it's in England, I can't go, so I'm gonna be watching that, on Saturday, so I will not be doing any videos. I may do a few, but, that's gonna be pretty much it. But I will not promise anything, but rest assured, this week, come hell or high water, I'm going to have those two TMH ones ready next week. I already have like a pretty good idea how the Bugsy and Harley series will go, and I have a pretty good idea how the Bugsyverse storyline is gonna go. So I'm gonna just go from there. See you guys later. Oh yeah. Before I get out of here, go and see Eddie Z Kai. It's just a big batch of the Heritage Saga. It's like parts of the Heritage Saga kind of in one big part, and it's like redone. If you like Eddie Z like I do, you should go see it. It's fucking awesome. And yeah, it may be done with sprites like a lot of things, but it is fucking awesome. So I think you should go check it out. See you guys later. I mean, at least this person's doing it. At least this person's actually isn't trying to stop like a certain earthworm we all knew that stopped wanting to do Super Mario Bros. Z, and instead wants to draw all the stuff on for Infinity. Or is it Ink Bunny he's drawing on? I forget. But in any case, you know, check that out. And during this recording, you should go check the fundraiser out. They only have a little bit during the time of this recording. So if you want to donate, you can. If you don't want to, that's okay. I'm not forcing you. No one is. Don't act like anybody's sitting around here forcing you. Because no one is. No one's putting a gun to your head asking you to do this. Just if you want to do it, it's there. If you don't want to do it, no one's forcing you. So don't act like they are. And the only reason I say that is because when people ask for donations, some of you act like arrogant assholes. So I just kind of want to say that. So, see you guys later. I am Bugsy, your chaotic joker. Maybe I should just be called the chaotic joker. Well, but really, I'm your chaotic jester, and I'll see you later. No, I'm still keeping chaotic jester.